All right. So you, these are the four phases of ventilation. You must understand these four phases. The first phase is change from expiration to inspiration. The second phase is inspiration. The third phase is inspiration to expiration. And the fourth phase is expiration. So you must understand there are four breaths, and the ventilator does not know when to go from A to B, B to C, C to D. We are going to teach the ventilator when to go from A to B, B to C, C to D. Kanchan, are you understanding this? We are going to tell the ventilator. The ventilator does not know anything. We are going to tell the ventilator, how it is supposed to be going. So Kanchan, you know, I can see only you on the screen. So you must nod your head when I ask you, okay? So that I know that I'm audible. All right. Change from expiration to inspiration, inspiration, change from inspiration to expiration and expiration. This is something that we are going to decide. The ventilator does not decide it. We decide it. So how do we do this? So for any breath, there are three inspiratory phase variables. I call it tender loving care, TLC. So T is trigger, L is limit, and C is cycle. So we will understand what all this means. You can talk of every mode based on trigger, limit, and cycle. So if somebody asks you what kind of mode this is, you have to describe it in terms of trigger, in times of limit, and in times of cycle. Okay, we will explain to you, I will explain to you what it is all about, what is trigger, what is limit, what is cycle. And a mode is a way of delivering a breath via a specific ventilator. Now you must understand that all ventilators, what is showed as volume control on trigger, maybe assist support on somebody else, maybe assist control on something else. So the names are various. For example, in our Dräger ventilator, you have ASB, that is CPAP. Okay, pressure support, that is. Whereas on other ventilators, it will be called as pressure support. You know, in other ventilators, there'll be another name. It is like this. Xerox, jisko bolte hain, Xerox. Actually, wo Xerox nahi hai. Wo actually photocopier hota hai. What we are seeing outside, it is a photocopier. Lekin hum log kya bolte Xerox? हम लोग वैसा फोटोकॉपियर का अलग 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 नाम होते हैं. कोई इसको किधर जेरोक्स बोलते हैं, किसको कॉपी बोलते हैं, किसको और कुछ बोलते हैं. हम लोग को जेरोक्स पता है, समझ में आ रहा है. सिमिलरली द वन मोड विल हैव डिफरेंट नेम्स, बट टू अंडरस्टैंड द मोड यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड ट्रिगर, लिमिट एंड साइकिल. कंचन, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस? एवरीवन अंडरस्टूड दिस?
या respiration or normal respiratory cycles ke four phases, or they are ABCD, they are in the ventilator.
ABCD is on the ventilator, whereas trigger, limit, cycle is something that we will describe a mode. Koi bhi mode, volume control low, pressure control low, pressure support low, ye sab mode ko describe karne ke liye, we have to talk about trigger, limit and cycle. Then only we can understand this. Okay, so I am now going to some of the modes that we know of. Okay, so the first mode that we're going to talk about is continuous mechanical ventilation, also called as volume controlled mode. Volume controlled mode. Jabhi bhi volume control bola jata hai, matlab the ventilator is controlling the volume. Agar pressure control bola jata hai, ventilator is controlling the pressure. Control ka matlab ye hota hai ki they are giving some breaths. They are giving some breaths. So volume control agar bolega, to volume breaths are delivered. Pressure control bolega, to pressure breaths are delivered by the ventilator. That is why this is called as a controlled mode. Ek zamane mein, jab tum ambu bag, when you are using an ambu bag, you are not assisting the patient, you are pushing the ambu bag. That is controlled mechanical ventilation. So in the past, there was no way that the ventilator could understand when the patient is delivering a breath. That was called as controlled mechanical ventilation in the past. Ventilator never knew when the patient is breathing or what is happening. Now we are in a different era where the ventilator understands when we are going to take a breath. That is why nowadays there is no controlled mechanical ventilation. There is assist control. That means the ventilator will realize, "Are, this patient is taking a breath. Let me give a breath." That is how the ventilator realizes. Clear on this? Clear on this? Huh? So now, when you say controlled mechanical ventilation, there is volume control and there is pressure control. Okay, now let's go to TLC over here. Now, what is trigger? Trigger means how it starts the breath. Okay, how does the ventilator start the breath is called as trigger. Okay, what is limit? Limit is how the ventilator controls the breath. Up to what limit the patient controls the breath. And what is cycle? Cycle is how the ventilator goes from inspiration to expiration. I'll just repeat this. Trigger, limit and cycle. Trigger means how does the ventilator start the breath. Okay, that is trigger. How does the ventilator start the breath is trigger. How the ventilator controls the breath or stops the breath is limit. You know, you have an inspiration, you have an expiration. So inspiration kitna kabhi band karne ka, that is limit. And when a cycle means, how does it go from inspiratory phase to expiratory phase? So what is the difference between limit and cycle? Limit, what is the difference? Kanchan, can you tell me the difference between limit and cycle?
So when we set the limit, we can set the cycle. I mean, inspiratory and expiratory phase.
No, that's not how it is. So I'll tell you what the limit is. The limit means that, okay, tumne breath chalu kiya, inspiration kabhi hold karne ka hai. Inspiratory phase khatam nahi ho raha hai. So for example, if I take, if you can see me, if I'm taking a breath, I took a breath, I stopped here. But my inspiration, expiration has not started. Now I started my expiration. So my limit was, this was my limit. But I have not gone into expiration. When I go to expiration, that is called a cycle. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Am I clear? So trigger, limit, cycle mein difference hai. Trigger means that, okay, I'm starting the breath. Limit means I am stopping giving that inspiration. Okay, and cycle means I'm converting from inspiratory phase to expiratory phase. Clear on this? Huh? So now let's look at one question. Yeah, tell me, ask me.
So what is this difference between inspiratory phase and stopping the inspiration?
Okay, so now if I take a breath of 6 breaths a minute, okay, say let me take 10 breaths a minute. If I take 10 breaths a minute, okay, that means one breath in 6 seconds. If I say 10 breaths in 60 seconds, means one breath has got 6 seconds. Okay, now in 6 seconds, you will have one inspiration and you will have an expiration. That is one breath cycle. In that inspiration, now you, if you have set in I ratio as 1:2, that means 2 seconds will be inspiration, 4 seconds will be expiration. Clear on this? Now, I tell the patient to take a breath. He may finish so now, what have you decided? 2 seconds inspiration, 4 seconds expiration. Now, unfortunately, the patient decides to finish his inspiration first 400 ml directly in the first second of the inspiratory phase. Those second time inspiration, but he finishes his inspiration at first second only. In 1 second only. That means he has finished his breath, but he has not gone into expiration. So the ventilator will wait for one more second and then go to expiration. Clear on that now?
Yes.
Clear on that? So the limit was, okay, give 500 ml and stop. So it has given to 500 ml and it has stopped, but it has not gone to expiration. To go to expiration, it needs one more second. That is called as cycling. Clear on this? Am I clear? Everybody is clear now? It's a very important question that she asked.
Sir, and one more question.
Clear what it is all about? Niharika, are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Ruchika, are you clear? Everybody is clear. Yes, Swapnali, are you clear? Kanchan, you're clear? Kanchan, any more questions?
This is applied to all the modes or it is on all the controls?
All modes. In all the modes, it remains the same. So you must understand trigger means what? Trigger means how to start the breath. That means the ventilator is going to decide or you're going to tell the ventilator how to start the breath. When you say limit, it means how to finish the inspiratory phase. Inspiratory, just the inspiration. Okay. And cycle means how to go from inspiratory phase to expiratory phase. I will explain this once more so that now when we go ahead, it should be very clear for everyone. So if I have got 10 breaths in 1 minute, that means 6 seconds is one breath cycle. Okay, in 6 breaths is one breath cycle. That means that breath cycle has got inspiration and expiration. Okay, now you decide to give 1:2. When you say in 6 seconds, I'm going to give 1:2 inspiration and expiration. That means there's going to be 2 seconds inspiration and 4 seconds expiration. 1:2. Okay, so there is going to be 2 seconds inspiration and 4 seconds expiration. Now you tell the ventilator that give only 500 ml. Okay, you tell the ventilator give only 500 ml. Now when you tell the ventilator give only 500 ml, what happens? The ventilator gives that 500 ml. But if it gives that 500 ml in 1 second, it has limited. You have limited the volume to 500 ml. So 500 ml has gone in. Okay, unfortunately, you have 1 more second for expiration. So it goes to 500 ml. It waits for that 1 second to go and then goes to expiration. Clear on this? That cycling from inspiration to expiration is called a cycle. Whereas the limit is what you have decided that itna deke band karna hai inspiration. Clear on this? There's a difference between inspiration and inspiration phase. You understood that, right? Now everybody is clear? Okay. Now we go to the ventilator. Now look at this. This is controlled mechanical ventilation. Now, what did I say about controlled mechanical ventilation? It is like an ambu bag. You know, the ventilator does not know that the patient is breathing, not breathing, nothing. Okay. So now let us look at these graphs. These are called as scalars. We will look at it, how it looks at in the computer also, on the monitor also. But this is called as scalars. On the x-axis, there is time. On the x-axis for all these graphs, there is time. Okay. On the y-axis, if you see on the right side, flow is there on the top graph, pressure is there on the ground lower graph, and volume is there on the lowest graph. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Pressure, flow, pressure, and volume versus time. Now, this is controlled mechanical ventilation. So now concentrate on the volume part of it. On the volume part,
स्टॉप हो गया है वीडियो आपका.
सर कांट हियर यू.
आपका वीडियो स्टॉप हो गया
है. ऑलराइट, कैन यू हियर मी नाउ?
यस सर.
यस सर.
सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग बैक टू कंट्रोल्ड मैकेनिकल वेंटिलेशन. सो इफ यू लुक एट दिस ग्राफ, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर ऑन द फर्स्ट ग्राफ, इफ यू रीड कंट्रोल्ड मैकेनिकल वेंटिलेशन मींस the trigger is what? What is the trigger here? Kanchan, can you tell me the trigger here? How does a ventilator start the breath? I'll explain to you. See, how does a ventilator start the breath? I decided that the patient should get 10 breaths in a minute. I decided that. Since I decided that you have to give 10 breaths in a minute, means I told the ventilator that every 6 seconds you give a breath.
Yes,
sir. I decided that, right?
Yes.
Since I decided how much breaths to give, that means that the what was the trigger? The trigger was time. I said every I want to give 10 breaths in 1 minute. That means every 6 seconds, please start a breath cycle. So the trigger was time. I decided that when I said frequency 10, I decided that every 6 seconds give a breath. Every 6 seconds give a breath. So the trigger was time. Now, what is the limit? Now, here, if you look at it, I have told volume control ventilation. So the limit was volume, tidal volume. So the limit was tidal volume. I said at 6 seconds, give a breath of 500 ml tidal volume. That is why the limit is volume. Can you see the limit? It is volume. Okay, volume. And how do you know that it is a limit is volume? Because if you look at the volume trace, it is very regular. It is the same volume trace. मतलब 500 ml पहला ब्रेथ में गया, 500 ml सेकंड ब्रेथ में गया. देयर इज नो चेंज इन इट बिकॉज़ आई डिसाइडेड टू गिव 500 ml. एंड व्हाट इज साइक्लिंग? साइक्लिंग इज अगेन टाइम. बिकॉज़ आई टोल्ड द वेंटिलेटर दैट एट 6 सेकंड्स यू स्टार्ट द ब्रेथ, एट द एंड ऑफ 6 सेकंड्स स्टॉप द ब्रेथ. सो नाउ आई नो द ट्रिगर, आई नो द लिमिट, एंड आई नो द साइकिल. ऑलराइट, नाउ समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू फॉर डॉक्टर्स एंड नर्सेस इज दैट you see the flow waveform. When it is a square waveform, it's like a square, na? When it is like a square, it is called as a square wave pattern, which is characteristic for volume control mode of ventilation. Okay, in the usual ventilators, if you have a square waveform pattern, it is called as volume control mode. Now in the volume control mode, now apart from trigger, limit, and cycle, there is one very important thing that you have to talk about, is the variable. In a ventilator, there are some things that we can control. There are some things that we cannot control. Okay, so that the patient controls. For example, here trigger, limit, and cycle we are controlling in volume control. But what is going to change? Pressure. The pressure is going to change. All right. So if you look at it, here the pressure is varying. If you look at the graph of pressure, pehla straight hota hai, fir thoda aur slope ho jata hai, fir thoda upar jata hai. So the pressure varies. So this is called as. So if I want to describe this mode, I will call this mode as, sir, this is controlled mode of ventilation. The trigger is time, the limit is volume, and the cycling is also time, but the variable is pressure. But the variable is pressure. That means to say, if the patient's body changes, you put a weight on his body, you put fluid in his body, the pressure will alter, volume will not alter. If you reduce the, if you narrow the endotracheal tube size, okay, the variable is going to be pressure. The volume will not change, the pressure will change. So this explains that if you want to understand the patient, you need certain parameters on the ventilator to make you understand the patient. Okay, this is controlled mechanical ventilation. Clear? Huh? Now, let us go to assist control. Controlled mechanical ventilation nowadays is not there in ICUs. It is always assist control. When I say assist control means the breath is triggered by the patient. The patient decides when to give the breath. If the patient does not breathe, the ventilator gives the breath. If the patient does not breathe, the ventilator gives the breath. Am I clear on this? Okay, that is, this is called as assist control. Okay, now let us look. So we set a rate on this ventilator. If the patient breathes more, he gets more breath. That is the meaning of assist control. Now look at this, how it looks like. In assist control, the flow remains the same. It is a square flow pattern. On top, it goes up, inspiration, down it comes, it is expiration. If you look at it, inspiration is a square flow pattern, whereas expiration is a triangular pattern. This was there in the earlier graph also. Why is this a triangular pattern? Because flow, when the expiration is a passive process. So the volume, the flow is reducing in the body. That's why it is showing like an upward triangular process. Whereas inspiration is an active process done by us. We are doing it. Okay, we are giving that breath. That's why it's a square flow. It's fully controlled. Whereas the expiratory flow is not controlled by us. It is passive process. That's why you have that, that sloping in the triangle over there. Clear on this? Huh? This is called as flow pattern, which is similar to what we saw in controlled mechanical ventilation. Look at the volume down. The volume is constant. The first the first breath, the second breath, the volume is completely constant. So this is that the limit is the volume. The cycling again is the time. Okay. Huh? But if I look at what is the trigger, see this, that the patient is breathing now. And the ventilator gives the breath. The patient takes a negative breath. That is what the inspiration is. And then the patient gets a breath, positive breath. You got the point? Huh? So if I run back, what is the difference in assist control and controlled mechanical ventilation? The trigger is the patient. The trigger is the patient. And then the ventilator delivers the breath. So the pressure varies. The pressure varies. But you can easily see a trigger, inspiratory trigger. Clear? So this is the meaning of assist controlled mechanical ventilation. Clear? Assist control. So so Ruchika, can you tell me how do you describe assist controlled mechanical ventilation, assist volume controlled mechanical ventilation? Describe this to me.
Sir, in assist volume control ventilation, the trigger is given by the patient.
Yes.
The negative wave, which is, that is the inspiration, which is given by the patient, and the positive one is given by the ventilator.
Very good.
And
limit,
the cycle is the time. Limit is the time. The limit, sir,
limit
is the
limit means you have decided to give what you are controlling? Volume.
The volume.
So it is, the limit is volume. The trigger is the patient. The limit is the volume because you are controlling the limit. And the cycle is time because the I ratio you have decided. Clear on this?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Let us go back to another mode of ventilation. Now, what is this mode? Now, if you look at this mode, what is happening in this mode? In this mode, what is, see, this was controlled mechanical ventilation. Now we are going to this mode called as pressure control. Till now we were on volume control, now we are in pressure control. So Niharika, what do you see different here among the earlier graph? I'm showing you one graph here, Niharika, and I'm showing you another graph here. What is different?
So the pressure, the flow waveform is triangular.
Very good. Very good.
And the pressure waveform is constant.
Very good. So Shraddha, to the Swapnali, to Shahul, whoever are there, understand this, what is happening over here. So what Niharika says is absolutely right. In the pressure control mode, the flow waveform has now become decelerating. This is called as decelerating waveform. Whereas the flow waveform in controlled mechanical ventilation was square flow waveform or constant flow waveform. So in usual ventilators, older generation ventilators, the pressure controlled flow waveform was decelerating waveform. It decelerated from top flow and came down to zero flow and then went into expiration. So decelerating waveform. But most importantly, what you are also seeing is there is a set pressure control. See the pressure control level, it is set there, it becomes flat there. It becomes flat on the second breath, flat on the third breath. And all the pressure, if you look at on the y-axis, is the same. The pressure on the y-axis is the same. This is called as pressure control. What is varying over here? It is the tidal volume. Look down on the tidal volume, the third figure. The tidal volume is going up. Then second breath is down, third breath is up. Can you see that? Can you see that? Huh? Yes. So if Niharika, if I ask you, or Shahul, is Shahul there? Is Shahul there?
Sir, is the flow is also changing?
Flow is not changing. Flow is decelerating waveform. It is just decelerating. Isse pehle square flow waveform tha, abhi decelerating waveform. That is the only difference. All right. Huh? So now if you look at this, the trigger is what? The trigger is, what is the trigger here, Kanchan?
The trigger is
time, because there is no negative time. Pressure at all. Trigger is time. What is the limit?
Pressure.
Yes, the limit is pressure. You decided to give X amount of pressure, the ventilator is giving that much amount of pressure. What is the variable here? What is the cycling here?
Cycling is time.
Again time. Cycling is again time. And what is the variable here?
Volume.
Very good. Volume. Okay. Now, have you understood this? Huh? Pressure control. Now, if I make this assist pressure control, it is going to look the very similar situation. Wait, hold on. Let me see what the assist. It will just have another. Okay. Okay. So now you have understood this much, right? You understood this much till now?
Huh? Sir, in that pressure control graph, that middle flow is less than the earlier. There is a variation,
that will change because the volume keeps changing. You understand? Since the volume keeps changing, the look of the graph will slightly change with going flow going up, flow going down. That will occur because the volume is changing. When you talk about trigger limit cycle, we will talk about trigger limit and cycle based on pressure and volume, not on flow. Okay, that's how we talk about it. So you know what we can do? We can now go to, go to another screen and show you the ventilator. Okay, then on the ventilator, we'll see how it looks like. Okay, just hold on. Okay, all of y'all just hold on.
Yes.
Let me just share another screen for y'all and we will take it from there. 1 second. Okay, can you all see the screen now?
No, sir.
You can't see a screen?
No, sir.
No.
1 second. Okay, wait, hold on. Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
So, see, when you start the ventilator, you know, there is a self test. Can you see the self test happening? Can you see the self test happening?
No, sir.
No, sir. Nice.
On this.
Asha,
that cancel.
Hold on. I will get it again for you all. 1 minute, okay? Share screen. दिख रहा है तुम लोगों को स्क्रीन दिख रहा है? What screen are you seeing, Ruchika?
So I can see like the dragger वाला जो sharing. Yeah, now, simulation.
Can you see the ventilator?
Please wait while the simulation starts up.
Now, can you see your ventilator? No.
No.
Oh, I don't know why it's not coming. Sometime back it was showing properly. Let me just see once more. One minute, just hold on. Everyone just hold on. What screen can you see now?
So your...
Can you see something now?
No, sir.
How come nothing is coming? I sometime back did it very well. It came also. Let me just say, search. Okay. 1 minute, huh? Control, delete. Task manager. Come out of this. End task. Microsoft PowerPoint. End task. And now, let me open up that screen once more for y'all. Okay, so elements, disk manager, Avita Excel. Okay, wait. Hyderabad posture, known as Avita trainers. Start Avita trainers. Countdown, presentation, poster, Hyderabad. Okay. Okay, what can you all see now? Ruchika, can you see something now?
So, yes, the dragger wala screen.
You are seeing that? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can you see the simulation now?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
No, it's coming again, sir. The please wait while the simulation starts up.
Achha, it's not loading, is it?
Yeah, it's not loading.
Then
just wait. Let me just see what to do now. Hold on. I think all control delete task manager. I need to stop this, end task, stop this, end task. Okay, now just a minute, okay? I'll get that done, not an issue. I understood what the problem is. Okay, start simulation. Now what are you seeing? Niharika, what are you seeing now?
So, no. We can see you.
Huh? Okay, you can see me only.
Not now.
Not
the
like the
okay
four people, four.
Just a minute, everybody, just a minute. Let me just get this right, because it's very important that we see the screen here. Niharika, what are you seeing now?
So, Dragger ka screen dikh raha hai, sir.
Dragger ka screen dikh raha hai, na?
Yes, sir.
Theek hai, so, just a minute, okay? Just a minute. So, you can see my desktop now?
Yes, sir.
You can see my desktop, right? Now, just a minute. You can see I'm changing stuff?
Yes, sir.
Yes, na? Theek hai, so then I'm okay. Hold on. Okay. A presentation. Okay, can you see now? Hello, Niharika?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now you can see?
Yes, sir.
I can see you.
Yes, yes.
Evita 4.
Yeah, okay, okay. So we are now.
Kanchan has hung up. Can you add her again?
Kanchan, okay. Yeah. One second.
Hello.
She's not there. She has to come in. If she comes in, I'll put her back.
Okay.
Hmm? Yes, she has to
I
come
have told
in.
Her. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. When she comes in, I'll put her back. That's not a problem. Okay. So now you see the screen now. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
So now if you look at the screen, this is how the screen opens up, okay? On the way on your machine. This is your machine. The machine opens up like this. All right. Very clearly it opens up like this. If you see on the top, there is a button on and off. Can you see that?
Hmm.
So this is the on and off button, which is there on the back side of your machine. Okay, on the back side of your machine, this button is there. There's a flap, this triangular flap that you open up. When you open up this triangular flap, there is a button which you press on, and that's how the machine starts up. Okay, clear on this. So if I were to switch this off, it will exit the simulation. So I'm not switching it off. So let me go to the, you can hear me, Niharika, right? You can hear, right?
Yes, sir, yes.
Yes,
yeah, yeah.
Yes, yes.
So look at the modes now. I'm going to go to the mode settings. Over here, if you look at it, there is a button called as mode settings. Let us see what all is there on this ventilator. So we just talked about mechanical controlled mechanical ventilation, right? CMV. We talked about controlled mechanical ventilation, where the trigger was time, limit was volume, cycling was time, right? Huh? This was what? A controlled mechanical ventilation.
Hello?
Hello?
सर आवाज नहीं आ रहा है हेलो हेलो सो कंचन वांट्स टू गेट इन बट अनेबल टू लॉग इन ठीक है लेट हर लॉग आउट एंड लॉग इन अगेन शी विल गेट इन ऑल राइट सो नाउ लेट मी गो टू द मोड कैन यू सी मोड सेटिंग्स रिटन ऑन टॉप राइट साइड टॉप Ruchika, can
yes,
you see
sir.
That?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Huh? So I'm going to mode settings now. And if you see over here, SIMV, IPPV, BIPAP, and ASB. There are four terms here: SIMV, IPPV, BiPAP, and ASB. What did I tell you? That terms will be different. The terms of a ventilator will be different, but you have to talk with respect to trigger, limit, and cycle. You have to talk with respect to trigger, limit, and cycle. So let us go to IPPV. Okay, when I go to IPPV, it is called as intermittent positive pressure ventilation. Whenever I select a mode, I have to select this small rotary knob over here. So when I select this rotary knob, see, this becomes black. When it is yellow means you want to do something. When it's black means you selected it. So I have selected IPPV now. Okay, I have selected IPPV here, right? So if you see on top, what has come? IPPV. Can you see that? It's come as IPPV, right? Now, when you look at IPPV, look at what is coming in those round 36, 520. These are the things that you can control. These are the things that you can control. I can control the FiO2. Okay, FiO2 means how much oxygen to give. I can control that. But on the modes of mechanical ventilation, when I say controlled mode of mechanical ventilation, my limit is the volume. So here is my volume. Can you see the volume here? 520. Okay, so I'm able to control the limit of this. So this is the limit I'm going to control. As I told you, I'm going to control the time. Okay, the time, because that is I'm going to cycle based on time. So look at this 12. This I'm able to control. So if I make this 10, which we had decided, means that one breath cycle is how much? One breath cycle is 6 seconds. One breath cycle is
6 seconds.
Now when I go to, wait, Kanchan has come in. I'll just get Kanchan online. Kanchan aa gayi kya? Wait, all right, Kanchan has gotten again. All right, so now when we look at this, I am controlling the volume, I am controlling the time. Now, if you look at the T inspiration 1.7, this is the IE ratio. So when I touch this and I start turning the knob, the IE ratio will change. Can you see that? IE ratio. Now to change the IE ratio, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to extra settings and put auto flow over here. Once I do that, keep the auto flow always on. Okay, keep the auto flow always. Forget about auto flow now. Okay. I will talk to you about auto flow later on, but always keep the auto flow on in our ventilator. Okay. So I'm on mode settings. Now see, I'm going to take my IE ratio. I'm going to go to my inspiration and I'm going to change this. See this? Am I changing this? As I change this, if I make it 1 second, means how much is my expiration? Niharika, if I make this 1 second, how much is my expiration?
5.
Yeah, expiration is 5 seconds. As simple as that. It is 5. Now, if I change this, I'll make this as 4 seconds. If I make this as 4 seconds, see what it is asking me? Should I increase my IE ratio between 1 and 1? Because I reached 3 seconds. Can you see that? Since I reached 3 seconds, means inspiration is 3 seconds, expiration is 3 seconds. So this is injurious ventilation. And that is why the ventilator is asking, should I increase my IE ratio? You got the point? I'll go back again to this. See, inspiration is 1 second, expiration is 5 seconds. I'm going ahead. I made it 2 seconds. Okay. Now inspiration is 2 seconds, expiration is 4 seconds. Okay. Now I'm going to increase this to 3. When I make this 3, it has gone to injurious form of ventilation. It's going to three. Okay, it's going to reach 3. And I'm pressing it. It is 3. Now, inspiration is 3 seconds. Expiration is 3 seconds. This is kind of getting injurious. Now, when I increase this further, the ventilator will ask me what? You really want to go above 1:1? It is like breathing like that. You know, it's breathing very big inspiration, very small expiration. Am I clear on this? So that's why this button is the inspiration expiration. Clear? And then this button comes as peep. Now what is happening over here? There is an A button. Can you see an A over here? Can you see the A beside this patient? This is the assist. Okay. This means to say that you have set a trigger. Now, where is the trigger? Go to this extra settings. Can you see extra settings here? When I press extra settings, you see this trigger? Huh? This is the trigger. You understand? You got the point. So now it comes as assist. Can you see the assist on top? Can you see assist on top now?
Yes.
Once
yes,
more, I'll show you. When I off it, what is going to happen? The assist is going to go. The assist is gone. This is what? Controlled mechanical ventilation. This is controlled mechanical ventilation. A means if the patient takes a breath, that A will come over there. If the patient takes a breath on his own, then the A will come over there. Okay. But if I want to start the patient to go on assist control, I press on here and I press this, the flow trigger becomes on. Can you see it become black? It's become black. That means the flow trigger has started. Once the flow trigger started, what happens to IPPV? It becomes IPPV assist. That means this is assist control. So now let's go back to our screen to understand what the waveforms look like. Sometime back, we discussed about waveform scalars where we had volume, pressure and time, right? Volume, pressure and flow, right? So how do you see that? How do you see all those things? See, can you see on top? You can see a small graph over here.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I touch this, see what it tells me. Do I want to see the pressure scalar? Do I want to see the flow scalar? Or do I want to see the volume scalar? It is telling me all three. It is telling me whether I want to see the pressure scalar, whether I want to see the flow scalar, or whether I want to see the volume scalar. Can you see this?
Yes,
so now at this moment, it is showing you the pressure scalar. Okay, so now let us go to the volume scalar first. This is the volume scalar. So I showed you the lower part of your mechanical ventilation. I showed you. See the volume? The volume remains constant. So if I look over here, your tidal volume is 520. What is your tidal volume here? 520. You saw that?
Yes, sir.
So 520 and 520 here, indicating very clearly that you are controlling the volume. You are controlling the volume. Right. Now, if I toggle around with the inspiration over here, I make this low. Say, for example, low. I made it low. Okay. Does it change the waveform? It doesn't do anything because volume, you have decided that. You have decided volume. What's happening now? After some time, it will go back and say, inspiration, I have to give in smaller amount. I want to give smaller amount. It is going to try to increase the inspiration. Okay, it's going to try to increase to 520. See, 466. Can you see it's become 466 there? Can you see it has become 466 here? Okay, in a couple of breaths, suddenly you changed everything. So it's going back to volume. Can you see that? Can you see that? It's going back to the volume, but it is going to give 520. Come what may, you do what you want to do. I will give 520. This is what it has decided, the ventilator. So it has now gone to 520. Can you see that now? Can you see that?
Yes.
So that means to say you have controlled the volume. You do what you want to do. You increase the RR. You increase the RR. You make the RR, say, 20. Okay, make it 20. For some time, the ventilator will think what is to be done. And then in 3 or 4 breaths, everything will become again the same. See, it's become 483 now. See, 501. Okay, 501 and 515. 518, 520, it has reached. You understand? So it will give same volume. You do what you want to do to the ventilator. It will give the same volume, but things will change on the ventilator. We'll come to that. So have you understood the volume control? Have you understood the volume waveform?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood the volume waveform? Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go to the pressure waveform. Okay. Now we're going to go to the flow waveform. You remember the flow waveform I showed you? It was a square flow pattern or a constant flow pattern. I showed you that, right?
Yes, sir.
I showed you it was a constant flow pattern. So we'll go to the constant flow pattern now. Okay. So let's go to the constant flow pattern here. Alarm limits. We'll go to the flow here. Again, I press this button. I press this button. Can you see flow written over here? I'm going to press flow here. So see what happens? It becomes like exactly what I showed you in the waveforms. Okay. So now let's look at it. I'll just change the alarm limits for you all. 1 second. Okay. Now you see what has happened. This part is the inspiration. Okay, this part is the expiration. So inspiration is controlled by the ventilator. Expiration is not controlled by the ventilator. Expiration is not controlled. It's passive. This is passive. So inspiration, expiration, inspiration, expiration. Clear on this? So now if you look at it, 520 has been delivered here. Then the flow has, you know, remained the same and then gone off. That is what has occurred. So inspiration, expiration. Clear on this? This is the flow pattern. Clear on this? Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I want this flow to be slow, if I want this flow to be slow, what will I need to do? I will need to increase my inspiration time. Now, what is the situation? 0.9. Okay, when I say 0.9, I'll come to that in some time. Wait, I'll come to that in some time. First, you understand this. You've understood this till now? You've understood this till now, flow pattern? Okay, now I'm going to go to the pressure pattern. Okay, let's go to the pressure pattern now. This is the pressure pattern. So if you look at the pressure pattern, what is happening? There is an inspiration, there is a plateau, and then there is an expiration. Okay, this is the pressure pattern. You can see the pressure pattern here very clearly. Pressure pattern is here. Now, since this patient is not breathing, since this patient is respiration is 20 here, respiration is 20 here, patient is not breathing, there is no change in the pattern of the pressure waveform at all. Have you understood, Ruchika? So when we said volume control mode, what did we say? We are controlling the volumes, we are controlling the times, and the variable is pressure. Now, when I say variable is pressure, look at this. Can you see the P peak here? 13. Okay. Now, if I'm going to change this, if I'm going to say, for example, change this tidal volume, I decide to change the tidal volume. The variable is the pressure. We remember the variable is pressure. So let me change the tidal volume. I'm going to make this 800. Okay, I'm going to make this 800. Say 760, I made it. See, now what's going to happen over here? Look at the peak pressure here. Is it? Let us see whether it goes up. 13, 16. Can you see it going up?
Yes, sir.
It's gone up. You see it's gone up? So the variable was pressure. See, this pressure is going up. Can you see this? So the volume remains constant. The time remains constant, but the pressure remains variable. Similarly, if I come down on this, if I come down on this, if I come down over here to say 300, okay, I came down to 300, and I pressed this. See what has happened to the pressures here. P peak was, wait, hold on. P peak was 17. Now see what's going to happen. This is going to come down on its own. See, P peak has come down. Can you saw this? Can you see that?
Yes,
sir. P peak came down, right? Can you see that the PP came down? Can you see that PP came down? So this means to say, in volume control mode, volume is constant, time is constant, limit is constant, but the variable is pressure. Clear? Now I'll give you an example of this. Now you have this patient. This is a normal patient. See, this is a normal patient that I'm showing you. Okay. Now I decide to intubate this patient and change the tube. I now change the tube to a 4-5 number tube. Okay. I change the tube to a 5 number tube. What have I done? I change the tube to a 5 number tube. Let us look what happens to the peak pressures. Okay. So no changes as of now. Let me go on the tidal volume to the higher, slightly higher tidal volumes, maybe 560. Okay. Now I'm going to change the tube to a 9 number tube. Okay. This was the tube that you initially had. Okay, this was the tube that you initially had. So the tube was showing a peak pressure of the ventilator was showing a peak pressure of 11 or 13, right? Can you see this? Now, if I were to actually increase or reintubate this patient and I put a smaller tube, I'm going to put a smaller tube, a 5 number tube. I put a 5 number tube. There is a possibility that the peak pressure should go up. Okay, there's a possibility peak pressure should go up. Let us see whether it goes up. Can you see it going up? It was 10, 11, 12. It has gone up to 12. 15, can you see? It's gone up. Man, the change of a tube has made a small change. Can you see it become 16? Can you see it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yes. It becomes 16. So the every time it is inspiring, the pressures are going higher because of the fact that your tube size is small. Because of the fact that the tube size is small. Every time there's inspiration, peak pressure is going up. So the tube size is a very important determinant in this case. So this explains to you in bedside, that peak pressure is going up. पीक प्रेशर जब भी ऊपर जा रहा है इसका मतलब यह है एयरवे में किधर तो भी प्रॉब्लम हो गया है. सो सिमिलरली लेट मी कम हियर. आई विल इंक्रीज द रेजिस्टेंस ओवर हियर. इफ आई इंक्रीज द रेजिस्टेंस ओवर हियर, ओके, व्हाट एम आई सपोज टू सी? आई एम सपोज टू सी द पीक प्रेशर गोइंग अप, राइट? लेट्स लुक एट द पीक प्रेशर. सी दैट? कैन यू सी इट गोइंग अप? कैन यू सी इट? एवरी इंस्पिरेशन इट विल गो अप. Expiration, it will come down. Inspiration will go up, expiration will go up. So peak pressure will tell you about resistance pattern on the patient. It will tell you about resistance pattern. All right. So So now let me convert this patient from this patient to an ARDS patient. If I convert to ARDS patient, please look at what's going to happen to the tidal. See now what has happened over here. Tidal volume, can you see 630, 560? It is, you have the volume control, but you have kept at 500. See, it's giving around 560 because the patient is breathing actually. See this lung marking changes when the patient breathes. Can you see this marking here? When the patient is breathing, this lung marking will change. So all right, huh? So now let me go to ARDS. I'm going to ARDS over here. Okay. When I go to ARDS, what is happening? Suddenly, what is going to happen is your tidal volumes will start varying now because it is very difficult for him to give the full tidal volume to this. Peak pressure keeps on changing. Can you see the peak pressure? Now, what is happening? Peak pressure? See this? Can you see this? What has happened to the peak pressure? It has started going up because now the patient is in ARDS. Since the patient is in ARDS, the peak pressure has gone up. So the volume has remained constant. See the volume 560, 555. Can you see it's almost constant? Okay. The time has remained constant, but the pressures have changed because, for example, you had this patient. I'm putting a normal patient. Okay. A normal patient came to you and you intubated this patient. When you intubated this patient, he basically came in with a blood pressure of 70 systolic. So you intubated this patient. Once you intubated this patient, you put him on the ventilator and now you saw the peak to be 13, 11. Can you see it? 11 and 10? Okay. You see 11, 10. You put up these settings. Now what happened? You found that the patient was hypotensive. So you decided to give truckload of fluids. So you give around 4 liters of fluids within the next 2 hours. In the next 2 hours, what happened? He was pancreatitis patient. You gave so much of fluid that everything extravasated into the lungs and that caused ARDS. So the oxygenation reduced. So immediately you increase the FiO2. You made it 100% because oxygenation reduced. You made it 80% because oxygenation reduced. But since the patient became ARDS, what are the changes that you are seeing now? Tell me what are the changes that you can see now. Tell me the change that you can see here. What is the change? Did anyone notice the change here?
Peak pressure goes up.
Yes, the peak pressure has gone up. Okay, the peak pressure has gone up, right? Have you understood the peak pressure has gone up? Have you understood that? Have you understood peak pressure has gone up?
Yes, sir.
Now, when there's that, so if you are on your rounds, first thing in the morning, you're seeing peak pressure. With peak pressure, what have you understood? If the resistance in the airway increases, the peak pressure goes up. If the patient gets into fluid overload, the peak pressure goes up, right? Now, there are two reasons for the peak pressure going up. One is the airway having a problem, and the other, the lung having a problem, right? So the airway having a problem is when we decided that the resistance goes up. For example, patient is asthmatic. Now let's go to asthma patient. Asthma, what happens? There is bronchoconstriction. Since there is bronchoconstriction, the airway resistance goes up, right? Okay. So let us see a normal patient. Let's take another example. So this is a normal patient. Okay. This is a normal patient. Now, when you put the patient on the ventilator, what have you seen? 560 you have added. You have added, you have put a respirator of 20. You have put PEEP over here. You have put, and what is the PEEP peak? The peak pressure is barely around 12 or 10. This is normal patient, right? This is normal. What is going to happen in an asthma patient? In an asthma patient, there is going to be increase in the resistance of the airways. So when I say airways, let us see what is going to happen. Okay. So I'm going to put asthma here. When I put asthma, tell me what is changing. Can someone tell me in the next breath what is going to happen? What is happening?
Peak pressure will increase.
Yeah, peak pressure is increasing. Yes, exactly. So you see the peak pressure, it has gone up majorly in asthma patient. The peak pressure has just gone up. It was 10, it has gone to 26, it has gone to 27. Since this is volume control, the volume remains the same, but the peak pressure, look at it, 27, it has gone to 27. Clear on this, it's gone so high, it has gone to 28 now. This is asthma. That means in ARDS and asthma, both the peak pressures are going up, but there are two different things. ARDS is problems of the alveoli and asthma is a problem of the airways. Asthma matlab bronchoconstriction ho raha hai. And ARDS matlab there is a problem in the alveoli. Now, that means you have to differentiate the pressures. You understand? You differentiate the pressures. What is causing this? So, the pressure in the airways is found by P peak, whereas pressure in the alveoli is done by something called as plateau pressure, P plat. Clear? Clear on this, P plat. So let us go to the P plat here. Where is the P plat here? So there is P peak here, VT here. Can you see one values measured here? Okay, when I say values measured here, I can see P plat here. Can you see P plat here?
Yes.
Plateau pressure. So this is the plateau pressure. All right, this is the plateau pressure. Now, I can get this here. If I see the 1, 2, and 3 screens, if I press this, you know, I can get different screens over here. You know, I can get different screens over here. I can get P plat if I want over here. Yes, many are, right? But P plat you can see here, it is 29. Okay, it is 29 here. Can you see this 29 here? Now, I'm going to make this a normal patient. Okay, I'm going to make this a normal patient. All right. So, when I make this a can you see the P plat coming down? Can you see this? Can you see?
Yes, sir.
So what has happened to the P plat? It is 11. Can you see this? Can everybody see this? Can you see it? Nihari, Kanchan, Swapnali?
Yes, sir.
Is now normal. It is 11 to 14. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make this ARDS. What is the P peak? It is 14, it is 11, and P plat is 14. Right? Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert this to a, for example, let us go to asthma first. I'm going to asthma here. Okay, I went to asthma and I changed this. What is happening to the P peak? 14, 12, P peak was 12. It is going to 15. P plat is also going up. 18, 18, 18, 21, 21, 21, 21, 24. Can you see it going up? This is asthma patient. Okay. Now to actually find the P plat, what do I need to do? I need to press here called as inspiratory hold. This button over here. So when I press inspiratory hold, you know, the waveform just stops. Once the waveform stops, I will get my P plateau pressure. So if you see the P plateau is somewhere around 22, 21. Can you see that waveform? Can you see that? See inspiratory hold, when I'm doing inspiratory hold, what am I seeing? See that? Can you see what is happening over there? See this? It is barely around 21, 22. Can you see this, right? Are you understanding? Once more, I'll show it to you. When I'm pressing inspiratory, what you're seeing over here is what the machine thinks the P plateau pressure is. 25, 25. Can you see this 25, 25 here, right? Can you see this? Can everybody see this? 25, 25. Now, actually to find the plateau pressure, what do I need to do? I need to press the inspiratory hold. Okay, when I press the inspiratory hold, see what's going to happen. The waveform is frozen. And now you look at where it is. This is somewhere around 23, 22. So that is why this plateau pressure that you're seeing is 22 now. Can you see it changed? Can you see that it changed? So to know plateau pressure, I'm pressing inspiratory hold. When I press inspiratory hold, I get my plateau pressure. Clear on this? Am I clear on this? So the plateau pressure is the pressure in the alveolus, whereas peak pressure is the pressure in the airways. Clear? So if your peak pressure goes up and plateau pressure remains where it is asthma. But if your plateau pressure goes up, it is ARDS. Clear on this? So let us look at what happens to normal and what happens to ARDS. This is normal. Okay. And I'm now going to ARDS. All right. I'm going to ARDS over here. So once I go to ARDS, see what's going to happen here. See the plateau pressure, sir? This is the plateau pressure, right? This is ARDS. Now ARDS patient is coming in. The ARDS patient, look at the plateau pressures. It's gone up. Can you see the plateau pressures going up? It's gone up majorly. Plateau pressures are gone up, going up, going up, going. It remains going up. Okay. And in some time, you'll see the plateau pressure to be higher, to be high. Okay. So plateau pressures are high. This is ARDS. Okay. I'm going to reduce the compliance further. Or ARDS go on here, Ruja. ARDS. All right. See this plateau pressure? So if now you understood what I'm talking about, this what we're talking about is volume control mein, there is going to be a variation in the pressures. Volume control mein, there is a variation in the pressures. It can either pressures can go up if the patient coughs on the tube, the pressures will go up. If the patient goes into ARDS, pressures will go up. If the patient has bronchospasm, pressures will go up. But the volume remains constant. Clear on this? Am I clear? Have you understood the buttons here now on the screen? Have you understood the buttons on the screen as of now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's go to pressure control. Now, so if I want to make this assist control, I just go to extra settings, press flow trigger, and this is on. It is assist control, all right? This is assist control. That's why it's called assist. Now, let us go to pressure control. What was pressure control? Trigger was time or patient. Limit was pressure. And we controlled the, and the cycling was time, right? So let's look at pressure control. This is pressure control. See pressure control now. What is happening over here? The pressure I have set, pressure control. I am controlling the pressure. I have put my pressure at 15. You understand? I put my pressure at 15. My rate I am controlling, 20. There is no volume over here, but till now there was a volume button, right? In IPPV, what was there? There was a volume button here. Can you see there's a volume button here? In BiPAP, what has happened? There is no volume button. That means what is varying? Tidal volumes. You understand? So here the trigger is the patient, because I have set a flow trigger to be on. Okay, trigger is the patient. Okay, the limit is the pressure. The limit is the pressure, right? And the cycling is time. Cycling is time. Okay, and the tidal volume keeps varying. This is the variable. So if you look at this, what is happening to the pressure? Pressure is constant. Pressure is constant. I have set 15 means 15 hi dega wo. Can you see it's 15? It's around 15. It's around 15. It's not going to change. All right, it's not going to change. Remain as 15. But if I let's see what the wave flow waveform looks like. Decelerating waveform, if you remember, decelerating waveform. So what happened? It is completely decelerated. It is not that square which we saw earlier in volume control. In volume control, how was it? Volume control, how was the flow? It was
square and triangle.
Yeah, in this was volume control flow. See this, how it was in volume control. This was how it was in volume control. See this? Okay, this was volume control. Now let us look at pressure control. It's become completely decelerating form. It's completely going down, going up, going down, going up. Okay, so this is decelerating waveform. Clear on this? Now let us look at the volume here. So this is the volume. See this? It's not constant anymore. Can you see the small dip here? Can you see the small dip here? Can you see this? It is changing. So the volume keeps on changing. See this 206, 528. It keeps on changing. So in volume, in pressure control mode, the volume is the variable, whereas the pressure remains constant. Pressure remains constant. So the pressure remains constant here. Pressure remains constant. So what is this button? This button is, if the patient takes a breath, how much pressure to give? That is this button. At this moment, there is no assist here. See, there is no assist here. There is no assist here. Now I want to make this patient take a breath, and I want to decide kitna breath dena. So if I move this and I put this, ASB comes in. Let's not go into this as of now. Pressure control, samajh mein aa gaya tum logo? Pressure, samajh mein aa gaya pressure control? Have you understood?
Yes.
Kanchan?
Yes, sir.
I can't hear you, Kanchan. I can't hear you. I can't hear you, Kanchan.
Sir, is this different than the pressure control mode which we set on the intubated patient?
Same only, this is pressure control mode, same thing.
So it shows PC control mode.
No, so some terminologies keep on changing. Even this is Evita 4 edition, Evita 2 edition will have a different terminology, Evita 1 will have a different terminology, Evita X will have a different terminology. But that is why you must understand what pressure control means. Here it is called as BiPAP, but this is actually pressure control.
Okay.
You understand? Why is it pressure control? How do I know it is pressure control? Because I am controlling the pressure. I am controlling. There is no volume button here. That is why I know this is pressure control. You understand? So the mode will not change provided you talk about it as trigger, limit, and cycle. Clear on this? Clear? Any questions? Any questions? Swapnali, Shahul, any questions anywhere? Any questions?
So how do you set a trigger in this? Trigger.
So here, see, there is a flow trigger. Can you see? It's already set. It's already on.
Okay.
It's already on here. Flow trigger. Okay? Flow trigger hai ye. Clear? That is the trigger. You understand now? It's already on. So this is pressure control. Okay. Why is it pressure control? Because pressure is constant. Time is constant, that's the time, and limit is pressure, and variable is volume. So what have you understood from this? See, what have you understood from this is whenever you have a patient on volume control, here you should have pressure seen. Whenever you have pressure control, here you should have volume seen. Samajh aa raha hai? And to change this screen, you just need to press this. You understand? To change the screen, you just need to press this. Simple. Huh? It will be happy if you get P plat over here. Okay, so if I want to see P plat, right? If it's volume control mode, what is important? Plateau pressure. Why is plateau pressure? Peak pressure, plateau pressure, both are important, because if the peak pressure goes up and the plateau pressure goes up, the problem is airway and ARDS. If only the peak pressure goes up, the problem is it is more of airway resistance. If only plateau pressure goes up, it is ARDS. So to know that, I need plateau pressures here to understand the patient. So for plateau pressure, if it's not there, see here, it's not there. RC, resistance, compliance, membrane, SpO2, and there is frequency, membrane, PPP. You can get plateau pressure here. And to get it over here, I need to press this thing. You see this configuration here? When I press configuration, screen, values, I now can change this. Now, for example, here there is frequency, minute ventilation. I don't need frequency. I may not need minute ventilation. So I can do one thing. I can convert this. I can convert this, press this, and search for plateau here. See this plateau? When I press plateau, it's not going up, but you understand, na? I can select it from here. Samajh mein aa raha hai, na? See this plateau? Can I see? Can you see this plateau? Where is it gone? Down. Can you see? I can select it from here. You understand? Understood, na?
Yes, sir.
Huh. So I. Clear on this? So now I see blood pressure. Am I clear now? Huh. So have you understood now? Have you understood this?
Yes.
Here, have you understood volume control and pressure control? Everybody has understood volume control, pressure control. Swapnali, you have understood?
Yes.
What about Vishranti? Vishranti, have you understood? Where is Vishranti? Have you understood? Vishranti, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Sushil, have you understood, Sushil? Any queries here? Any queries? Shall I go ahead?
Sir, on the boards? Regarding fluid overload, what do we get, like airway?
It will be when the fluid is overloaded, your airway will not be overloaded. Your lungs will be overloaded. So it will be like ARDS. Your plateau pressures will go up. Okay. That's why when you come in the duty, nurses and doctors should first see what your pressures are. What is the peak? What is the plateau? So that you know during your duty what is happening. You understand? So you'll be able to certain ki, abhi we discussed ARDS and we said the most important thing is to keep the plateau pressures low. So you know your ARDS in the first place, then what your plateau pressures are. And if it goes up, you know there is some problem occurring and something needs to be done. Clear? Huh? Now this was about volume control and pressure control. Now I'm going to go ahead to another mode. Okay. I'm going to go to another mode. Let me just get that mode out, mechanical ventilation.
So normal plateau pressure kitna target
rakhe? There is not less than 25. Less than 25. Okay. So I'll just brush through the whole thing again. So we did talk about this. We talked about control mechanical ventilation, assist control. Okay. Now we are going to something called as SIMV. All right. Till now, what did we do? Assist control. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
You can see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this was assist control. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put something called as SIMV, synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation. Synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation. Isme kya ho raha hai? Isme kya ho raha hai ventilator mein? Malum hai? You have decided, since it is mechanical ventilation, you have decided volume. That's why the volume is over here. You have decided the volume. You decided to give the patient tidal volume of 500 ml. So 500 ml there have tidal volume. ठीक है? हाँ. And you have decided to give the patient 10 breaths. 10 breath ventilator ने देने को बोला हुआ है. That means you have controlled the time there. But what has happened over here is you have also told the ventilator in the middle if the patient wants to breathe, let him breathe on his own. In the middle, if the patient wants to breathe, let him breathe on his own. Don't assist. Don't do anything. This is called as this is the patient's breath over here. This one is the patient's breath. Can you understand that? So in synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, intermittently it is mandatory and intermittently patient can breathe on his own. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Patient can breathe on his own. This is called as synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation. Now here if you look at trigger limit and cycle for these breaths, this part is patient's spontaneous breaths. This part is patient's spontaneous breath. So isme trigger is what? Trigger is patient. Limit is what? Limit is patient. Cycle is what? Cycle is patient. For these breaths, everything is done by the patient. It decides, patient decides what to do. Patient decides when to stop breathing. Patient decides when to go into expiration. This is spontaneous breaths. Clear on this? Whereas these breaths, what are the trigger limit cycles, Kanchan?
So which
on the other breaths? These breaths, the other breaths?
Sir, trigger is time.
Trigger is?
Time.
What is this then?
So patient's breath, that is trigger.
That's what the trigger is not, is the trigger time?
Sorry, sir.
So the trigger
is patient's inspiration.
The patient is a trigger. Patient is a trigger. What is the limit?
Limit is volume, what we decide.
Why? How do you decide that? How do you, by the graph? Look at this. This is a square waveform. Square waveform, normally volume control. Volume is the remaining the same on this and this. Okay. So volume, limit is volume. Cycle?
Cycle is time decided by us.
Yes, cycle is time decided by you. Okay. That's the rate that you decided. So clear on this till now, SIMV? Sushil, are you clear?
Sir?
Yeah. Go ahead.
So in SIMV volume, we have to decide. Volume should be constant, na?
So if you look at this, this is what have we written? Volume targeted ventilation. Okay. Volume targeted ventilation means ye jo IMV hai na, intermittent mandatory ventilation, this is decided by me. Okay. So that means I will have volume control. I will have the volume in my hand. I will have the time in my hand. But in the middle, the patient can breathe. You understand? Patient can breathe. Till now in volume control, what was happening? Patient could not breathe in the middle. Patient did not, it was the ventilator deciding all the breaths. Now the patient can breathe in the middle. So if I want to see this on the screen, how does it look? How does the SIMV look on the, let me see whether I can show that to you. Okay, 1 minute. Let me see whether I can show that to you. If I can show that, be good.
So the here pressures will be variable.
Pressures will be?
Variable.
Yes. No, pressures will be variable. It will be variable.
Okay. Even the volume will be variable, no?
Even the
volume will be variable.
Volume will be variable for the patient's breath. For okay. The patient's breath, not for the breath that you set. Okay. You understand? For example, can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
So I will just show you how it looks like on the screen also. All right. So simulation. Start simulation. Now let us set, let us check the, can you see the Dräger ventilator? You can see it, right?
Yes, sir.
SIMV. So let it self test itself. Here patient adult, I am selecting tube and I am now starting the ventilation and going to the modes. Okay, let it start. Okay, now can you Niharika, can you see the screen? Sushil, you can see the screen? Sushil?
Yes, sir.
Sushil, yes, you can see. Okay, so now I'm going to the mode settings and now I'm going to select SIMV. I've selected SIMV here. So when I've selected SIMV, look what all has come. One second, let me just switch on auto flow so that it doesn't confuse you. 1 minute. All right, see now what has happened over here. This is your FiO2, which you have decided. You are going to decide that tidal volume. See, you are setting. Can you see this? Niharika? Niharika?
Yes, yes, yes. I could see.
So you are setting the tidal volume. You are setting the rate, respiratory rate. That means if I make this 10, means 6 breath cycle, I am setting this. I am setting this. That why this the cycling is time. The cycling is time here. You understand? The tidal volume I've set over here. The only thing that I'm not setting over, if you look at this 520, 520, 520, 520, can you see this 520? Mm-hmm. Is if the patient breathes in the middle. If the patient breathes in the middle, he breathes. You understand? He breathes normally. There's nothing we can do here. So if I, for example, if I put this patient and I reduce my respiratory rate to 8, see it's only 10. Okay. Now I will increase his strength. I will make him breathe normally. Okay. I'll make him breathe normally. I've increased his strength now. Okay. Now what's going to happen over here? Maybe he'll breathe. Okay, let's see whether he breathes. I think this simulation does not have a breath. Well, the simulation does not have a breath, as I have shown you. Okay. So see, I have set 5. I have 5, but the patient is breathing. This is the patient's breath. Can you see that? Did everyone see this? This one is the patient's breath. He breathed on his own. Okay. Now, after 5 seconds, the ventilator will give. After this, I have put a breath rate of 5. So it will wait, it will wait, it will wait. If the patient breathes in the middle, it will breathe. Okay. And then suddenly it will give a breath. Okay. It's waiting, waiting, waiting. See, 12 breaths patient ka hi hai. Okay. Now, I will reduce the patient's strength to 0. Patient cannot breathe at all. So what will the ventilator do? No. If it will wait for the patient to breathe. If the patient does not breathe, the ventilator will give a breath. It's as simple as that. So now if I make the ventilator breath, if you want to see the ventilator breath, see this. Can you see the ventilator breath now? This is the ventilator breath. Can you see it? This is the ventilator breath.
So yes, sir.
You got the point. You got the point what's happening. Did you understand? Now what is varying over here? Variable is the peak pressure. See this? So if I increase this to 800, if I make this 780, look at the peak pressures. See this? Can you see the peak pressure changing? It was 10, it became 11, it became 14. See, it's becoming 15. So what is varying over here? Peak pressure. Okay. What will also vary is if the patient breathes in the middle, the mid ventilation will change. Clear on this? So now if you want to know whether it is the patient breathing or not, you have to look here. Can you see this? This, you can see this over here, this figure over here. This is the ventilator delivering a breath. When the patient takes a breath, now there will be lung sign over here, lung sign. Other option is you go to the values measured. You go to the values measured. Can you see over here VTASB? Can you see VTASB here? This is the patient breathing, if the patient breathes. Can you see frequency spontaneous here? Ruchika, can you see this? Can you see this?
Yes.
So this spontaneous means how much the patient is breathing. Frequency is the total breaths. Okay, you understand? So this is the total breaths. If the patient starts breathing, it will become, you'll start seeing what it is all about, SIMV. Okay, now, you have understood till now? Everybody has understood till now?
Yes,
sir. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get out of this now and Alright, so we go back to our PowerPoint. Okay, so have you understood SIMV? Has everybody understood SIMV?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is what SIMV is. So this means if you look at it, there is a patient trigger, a controlled volume, pressure is varying, and you have patient breathing in the middle. Now I'm going to go to something else. Now what is this? What is this? So this we talked about, this breath could be either volume control or this could be pressure control. Samajh mein aa raha hai na? This breath. So if I want to see that breath, let us go there. Okay. Look what has happened over here. Let me go back. Okay. So you have understood this much. इधर तक समझ में आ गया ना तुम लोगों? इधर तक समझ में आ गया बराबर? हाँ. अभी now what I am going to do is ये जो breaths है ना, these breaths that the patient is taking on his own, I am going to support these breaths. Now let me just go through the waveform once more for you. Inspiration, ventilator delivering a breath. Inspiration, patient taking an inspiration. Patient taking in breath himself. Patient taking inspiration. Patient taking breath himself. Patient inspiration, ventilator delivering a breath. Clear on this till now? Clear on this?
Hello? Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what I'm going to do is, now be careful. Now listen to what's happening over here. So now the patient takes a breath. The ventilator delivers a breath. The patient takes a breath. But now the ventilator supports this breath. And this support breath is called as pressure support. Can you see this? What is the difference between this and this? Look at this. Here, patient takes a breath, patient inspires, patient gets a breath, patient inspires, patient gets a breath on his own. Now what has happened? I have set a pressure here. So when the patient takes a breath on his own, a pressure supported breath is given. Now why am I saying this is pressure support and not pressure control? Because if you look at the waveform, there is a waveform that comes till here and then drops down from here. It drops down from here. Unlike pressure control. What was happening in pressure control? It used to come from here and end over here. You remember, no? You remember? What is pressure control? The flow waveform used to go from here and end till here. Clear on this?
Yes, sir.
What is happening over here? What is happening over here? You have a flow waveform that goes from here and does not end here. It comes and stops right here and then goes down to expiration. So this is a different breath completely called as pressure supported breath. Pressure supported breath. Till now we were, patient was breathing on his own over here. Now we have a supported breath. Now let us see what pressure support is all about. This is pressure support. Now what is happening over here? What is the trigger over here? Vishranti, what is the trigger here? Vishranti, is Vishranti there? Vishranti is there? Vishranti, what is the trigger here? Okay, Niharika, what is the trigger here?
Sir, inspiration.
What is the trigger?
Patient's breath.
Very good. The trigger is the patient. What is the limit?
Limit will be the pressure we have set.
Yes, it's a pressure. You have set a pressure, you know. So that is the limit. What is the cycling?
Cycling will be the patient again.
So the cycling here is flow cycling. If you look at it, what is happening over here? Flow इधर तक आ गया, फिर इधर तक आ गया और फट करके बीच में flow के बीच में cycle कर गया वो. It has gone, it has inspired, decelerating waveform and suddenly expired. See this, this expiration is common to this place. It's common to this place. You see, it's common. So it is flow cycled. इसका मतलब क्या हो गया? जब flow तेरा से 100 था, the sum of the flow is 100. When it reaches 25% of 100, it cycles. When it reaches 25% of 100, it cycles. The flow here was 100. Okay, the flow here, say for example, 100. Okay, when it reaches 25% of the flow, it cycles. That's why this is called as flow cycled ventilation. Now, if I convert TLC here, the trigger is the patient. The limit is pressure support, is a pressure, and cycling is flow cycling. Clear on this? Am I clear? Huh? So now if I want to go to this breath, this means I have set a pressure. So there are two kinds of breaths here. One is the volume controlled breath signified by a square waveform and varying pressure with normal volumes. And you have a where here the trigger is the patient, the limit is the volume and the cycling is time. Whereas here you have a second breath where the trigger is the patient, the limit is the pressure and the cycling is flow. Clear on this? So this is SIMV pressure support. So if somebody wants to tell this, you will say this particular mode has got two breaths. One breath, which is a volume control breath because it has got triggered by the patient, limit by volume and cycling by time, and you have a pressure supported breath where the patient has a, there's a patient trigger, there is a pressure set limit, and there is a flow cycled ventilation. This is SIV pressure support. Clear now? Okay, now
sir, question.
Yeah, tell
sir, hello. How does it differentiate from the flow cycled and time cycled ventilation? I mean,
that's the difference. So the difference is this only: I am not setting time here, there is no time button here. The ventilator decides, you know, the ventilator decides. So for example, if I show what happens in pressure support, let us go to pressure support on our ventilator. Okay, we will open our ventilator and let us see what happens in pressure support on the ventilator. Till now you saw the buttons on the rest of the ventilators. Now what we're going to see is we're going to see the button on this. Okay, so let us see how it looks like. All right, you can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
All right, so I'm going to the simulation and let's see the simulation here. Okay. So startup chal ho gaya, self test is on, and self test gets over. Once it gets over, you will it will start off adult, pediatric, previous, and I'm switching on the ventilator now. Okay, now let us go to pressure support. Let's all go to pressure support. So mode settings, there is no pressure support here as of now, this is the button of pressure support. If I press this, as I told you, names can differ. You must understand how to look at it. So if I press this, what am I seeing here? Am I seeing time here? Am I seeing respiratory rate?
So screen hang ho gaya.
Screen hang ho gaya. So can you see anything here? Is there time here? In ASB, is there time here? Is there a frequency?
No, sir.
There is no frequency, right? There is no frequency here. Since there is no frequency, can I say this timed breath? No. Abhi tak frequency tha na. IPB mein kya ho raha tha? There was frequency here. So I was saying that, okay, 6 breaths cycle hoga, 7 breath cycle hoga. Agar 10 breath ka cycle, if I have said 10, it means 6 breath ka cycle hai. We decided all that. Okay. Now when I go to ASB, is there a breath? Is there a time here? No. So definitely cycling is not time. Definitely cycling is not time. Okay. Am I controlling pressure here? I'm not controlling pressure control. There is no pressure control at all. If you look at BiPAP, there was pressure control here. Isn't it? There was pressure control here. Can you see there was pressure control here? I was controlling pressure.
Yes.
Whereas here, I'm not controlling pressure here. There is no pressure here. Okay. I'm only going to assist. ASB means I'm only going to assist with a certain pressure. Since I'm going to assist with a certain pressure, I'm assisting with a certain pressure. So what is going to change here? The volume. The volume. You understand? The volume is going to change. Clear on this? So in assist support, see, there is, if the patient does not breathe, there is no breath. Can you see there is no breath? Can you see, is there a breath here? Apnea. You see what has happened? Apnea. It has gone to apnea. So if on pressure support mode, it is very essential to have something called as apnea ventilation on your screen. Can you see apnea ventilation? This always has to be on. Okay, so by mistake, agar samajh lo patient ko humne paralyze kar dala on pressure, we should never do it that. Agar patient ko paralyze kar dega, there will be no breath. There will be no breath at all. This is what is pressure support. Right? Now, let us make this patient breathe. Strength, I will increase the strength. And we'll try to increase his breath rate. Okay, let's see whether he breathes now. So can you see a tidal volume developing now? 515, can you see that? There's a tidal volume. Now, I'm going to increase the tidal volume a little bit further. I'm increasing my pressure support here. I'm making it 8, 10, I made it. Okay, see that? Can you see that? Can you see what has happened? A breath came in. Okay, breath came in, but tidal volume changed. Because I increased the pressure here, the tidal volume changed. Okay, the variable is tidal volume. I go to flow cycling and see how it looks like. Can you see how it looks like? See that? So I just stopped it, I just freezed it. So you have flow going up, coming down, and then once it reaches 25%, it cycles down. Can you see that? Did you see it?
Yes, sir.
Did everybody see it? It is a flow going up, decelerating, it reached 25% and it cycled down. This is flow cycle. This is flow cycling. Am I clear on this now?
Yes.
Okay, so now on the pressure support breath, if I want to, this tidal volume is too much. It's too much for my patient. I will just reduce this. If I reduce this, ASB, that is assistance, it will reduce the tidal volume. So if I come down here, if I reduce this further to say 4, 3, see what's going to happen to tidal volume here. See that? It reduced it. The tidal volume was reduced. Saw that? You understand? Tidal volume reduced. When I increase this, the tidal volume will go up. So what's going to happen to tidal volume? Look at the tidal volumes now. Can you see the tidal volumes? Am I clear?
Yes.
All right. So that was about. So on your screen, you need to know the frequency. You need to know the minute ventilation. You need to know all these things over here. Okay, because everything is varying over here. Everything is varying. Patient does everything on his own. Okay, so let me come out of this now. End task. Task manager. End task. Okay. So you can see the PowerPoint again. You can see the PowerPoint?
Yes, sir.
All right. So that was flow cycling, right? Now tell me what is this now. Can somebody tell me what this is all about? This one? So Kanchan, you want to try? What is this? Trigger limit cycle? How many bread types are there here?
So there are two bread types. One is pressure, one is pressure support.
So order. How do you say what is this first bread type? Trigger limit cycle batao.
So in that we set the plateau bread. It's pressure
trigger limit cycle. What is the trigger?
Time.
What is the trigger here? Look properly. What is the trigger here?
The patient's breath.
Yeah, the trigger is the patient.
Hello.
You can see the trigger. Yeah.
Hello. The screen is frozen.
ब्रदर हेलो हाँ नहीं मेरा फोन चालू हो गया उसके वजह से हो गया हाँ अभी आ जाएगा हाँ ऑल राइट सो कंचन कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट दिस इज दिस फर्स्ट ब्रेथ इज कंचन कैन यू हियर मी
सर यस सर द इंस्पिरेशन पेशेंट इंस्पिरेटरी ब्रेथ इज द ट्रिगर
हाँ पेशेंट इज द ट्रिगर व्हाट इज द लिमिट
प्रेशर इज द लिमिट
Pressure is the limit. Very good. What is the cycling?
Cycling is time cycle.
So for this breath, it is time cycle.
Time cycle.
Whereas, no. What about this breath?
Flow cycle.
Yes. So, but trigger, what is the trigger here?
Trigger is again patient's breath.
Trigger is patient. What is the limit?
Pressure.
What is the cycling?
Flow.
Flow cycle.
Because it has stopped here. So this kind of ventilation is called as SIMV pressure control plus pressure support. SIMV pressure control plus pressure support. Hear all this? And what we see at the end is this CPAP. This is what I showed you. CPAP in our ventilator is called as ASB. Okay, this is ASB. In our ventilator is called as ASB. That is called as CPAP. Now, what is something very funny over here? Look at this. The patient is breathing, patient ka koi rate nahi hai. Patient decides when he wants to breathe. So that is why the rate is varying over here. Okay, but what is important is there is a continuous pressure in inspiration and in expiration. Inspiration pressure is up, you see this, and expiration, the pressure is continuously up. pressure is continuously up. You understand? Pressure is continuously up. When the patient breathes, negative comes in. But pressure is continuously up. That is why this is called as continuous positive airway pressure. Okay, this is called as continuous positive airway pressure, CPAP. So on our ventilator, if you remove PASV, it will become CPAP. For example, if I go back to our ventilator, now, can you see the screen? Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
You are seeing the Dräger ventilator, right?
Ventilator
नहीं दिख
रहा है इसमें। ventilator नहीं दिख रहा है। CPAP plus slide
है। Just wait, wait. I need to stop this again. अभी Dräger दिख रहा है?
नहीं sir.
No, you're seeing it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so let us go to the simulation for CPAP now. Okay. Let the ventilator start. So, can you see the ventilator? Can you see the ventilator now?
Yes, sir.
All right. Yeah, so now I'm going to start the ventilator. And what am I going to do? I'm going to look at, can you see ASB here? Can you see ASB?
Yes.
Can everybody see this? Okay, now I am putting ASB here. Okay, so now what is this mode? What is this mode? Can somebody tell me?
CPAP.
No, this is not CPAP. This is not CPAP.
CPAP.
What is this?
CPAP.
No, what is this mode?
ASB.
What is this? What is the trigger limit cycle? Kya hai isme? What is the trigger here? See, in this mode, what is happening? In this mode, the patient is triggering. There is no respiratory rate here. The patient is triggering. That is why there is no RR button here. You understand? There is no RR button here. That is why the patient is triggering. Okay. Now, the limit is what? The limit is pressure. That is why the pressure is constant. This pressure is constant. Can you see the pressure is constant? You have set the pressure. You have set the pressure. And what is happening to the flow? The flow is cycling. You see this? The flow is going up, coming down, 20% cycling. So this is what? Pressure support. This is pressure support. Clear on this? I have supported the patient with the pressure. You understand? This is pressure support. Now, if I make this zero, this becomes CPAP. You understand? Okay. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
This is CPAP. There's a continuous pressure. Patient is breathing. Can you see there's a tidal volume here, 620? Patient is breathing. This means patient breathing. Respiratory rate is 12. Patient saas le raha hai. Patient ka respiratory rate 12 hai. He's breathing at 620 ml. Right? Now, I decide, let me give him some support. So what will I do? I will increase this. If I increase this, this will become pressure support. So now see what is going to happen. I now give him 11 pressure. Abhi 11 pressure tak jayega. Dekha, 11 pressure tak ja raha hai. 11 pressure tak ja raha hai. और उसका टाइडल वॉल्यूम वेरी होने चालू हो जाएगा. सी दिस, कैन यू सी टाइडल वॉल्यूम गेटिंग वेरीड बिकॉज़ आई हैव गिवन हिम प्रेशर सपोर्ट. नाउ दिस इज प्रेशर सपोर्ट विद पीप. व्हेन आई मेक दिस जीरो, दिस बिकम्स सीपैप, व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड. समझ में आ रहा है?
यस सर.
हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस?
यस सर.
राइट, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट basic modes. You need to know only this much in your practice. You don't need anything more than this in your practice. Anything more than this is for exams. Alright. All understood what I've spoken till now. you have understood SIMV, you have understood volume control, you have understood pressure control, and you have understood pressure support. Four modes you have understood properly now. Okay, so now next time you go to the ventilator, when so Niharika, if I ask you a question, if this patient is on volume control, what do you want to see on your ventilator? What would be the readings that you want to see on your ventilator?
So I would look for pressures.
Which pressures?
Peak pressures and plateau pressures.
Very good. Very good. Ruchika, wait. Swapnali, is Swapnali there? Swapnali?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If the patient is on volume control, what are the findings you will want to see?
The pressure.
Very good. You want to see the pressure in volume control. You want to see the pressure, that is plateau pressure and peak pressure. If the patient is on pressure support, what do you want to see? If the patient on pressure support, Shahul, are you there, Shahul? Shahul, are you there? Or Shraddha, can you tell me what will you see if the patient on pressure support, Shraddha? Shraddha, can you hear me, right? Unmute your mic and talk. No. Shraddha is not wanting to talk. Naraaz hai sab log se wo. Theek hai. Ruchika, pressure support. What will you want to see in pressure support?
So the flow cycling.
No. Pressure support on the ventilator. What are the readings you will want to see on pressure support? All the variables you want to see, you know, what you have said you don't want to see, you want to see the variables. So in pressure support, the respiratory rate will vary, so you want to see the frequency. In the pressure support, the volumes are going to vary, so you need the volumes. In pressure support, the peak pressures may vary, you want to see the peak pressures. Okay, so you want to see pressures, you want to see volume, you want to see frequency, because all these things are going to change in pressure support. You understand? So that is how you ventilate your patients. Clear on this? We haven't gone to NIV. We have just talked about invasive mechanical ventilation or modes of ventilation. Any doubts here? Any doubts for anyone? Any doubts for anyone? I suppose. So what I'm going to do is, all these things will be there on recorded also. Tum logo dekhna hai baad mein, you can see it again. Okay. Just go to the website and see it on that website. Theek hai, this is recorded and will be there on the website. All that we talked just now. Okay. Clear on this?
Yes. Yes, sir.
No doubts here, right? So now please, when you're touching the ventilator, do it properly. All right. Next time we'll go to advanced modes maybe. And slowly we'll go. Or maybe we'll repeat the whole thing. Whatever you all want. Okay. But we need to understand this again. Okay. We need to understand this properly. Okay then. We'll end for now. Any doubts? Any doubts anywhere? No doubts, right? Shaul?
No.
Shaul, any doubts? Shaul? Vishranti? Shraddha? Any doubts? Shaul, hai ki nahi, bhagya rakhte ho. Theek hai. All right, see you then. Bye-bye. We'll end for now.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.